Hello and welcome. It is that of the 5th day of April 2019. My name is Derek, and all bets trades of the like within each his own risk and their own reward, but not much for me to state. In fact, one of the things I'm saying, it's very difficult with gold anyway to try to determine where we stand from here. I do like the fact that it's not breaking down, but at the same point, it's not breaking out either. Yesterday's session having a little hiccup below the 1285 and a little bit of this white line going down, which means it is has been rallying from this very tight lower end of this range. Meanwhile, it's a declining 18 lows, and overall it's a start of a possible wave to the downside or a newly declining average. But along the way, as far as reversal of trend, support established back to the band, it went a bit above it, so be it. It didn't break out from there. So now it's leaving the band, and well, if it gets down below this, you can state whether we're going to enter into bear market territory within the daily, but it hasn't done it as of yet. And there's no sign yet of breaking out to change it and get, because getting above here, getting the 18 average of highs and even to the 1321 Fibonacci level really puts this in the upper end of what has now been a neutral size market since it got up to there at the start of the year, which is in the area between 1281 and with one pierce above it, that of 1324. Silver in a very similar camp as well. And it has been had this day yesterday where it barely broke down again. It managed to regain itself back to this upper end. And again, today's session testing this little area, barely getting into the 18. Same sort of deal. Support has been established. It was established originally in here. And it really didn't take it down by too much here, which I find relatively interesting. Maybe this is the okay, lower low, barely resist it, break down. Either way, from a up move that it has had, technically it is still above, higher than I'd really want to see it come down to, because around 61, just general area here. That's what would kill this uptrend from point A November lows to the point B early 2019 highs is not able to hold 61.8% of its move, which would approximately come in at around 14.5. So therefore, if it makes another leg lower, that's going to come down to what would be a much more bigger test. But it's got a decent ways to go to get this thing back into a bullish territory, as it first has got to get up to the 18 highs at previous resistance. And then getting above that, you'd start to talk about, okay, well, this thing might be ready to go for maybe a break above that 16 handle. The fiat index of the US dollar against other or many or some of the other top currencies, quote unquote top, amongst the world is showing a breakout pattern from this 18 average of lows, and well, we might have some very volatile moves, you know, sessions that might go up 0.75% or close to it, maybe a half, 0.8 maybe 3 or 4 days up 1.5 or two. We'll see what it does, but getting out above this, maybe precious metals go down, maybe they just go sideways a little bit or barely go up. And I say it that way because within the strength in here, we aren't seeing gold and silver showing really anything of major bearish signs. And yeah, maybe all it is on a breakout above it is that silver 61.8% test is all it'll be. And gold, same sort of deal there as well. Maybe just taking another leg lower. And so be it. And of course, if it doesn't break out, we're at this level of resistance. Some key areas of support were at the rising 18 lows at 96.75. And just even in this whole area, you got so many different potential levels because it really has to break down below this 96 just to get it even off of neutral, to attempt to get it off of neutral territory. Because if it ranges in here, I mean, that's all it is right now is a bullish range at this side going sideways. And this was just a nice volatile failed breakdown, but not much of a fast move after it. But I mean, it's a Dixie DXY. I'm finished with this for the day. I mean, I spent way too much time on this coin. We'll call it. Let's go to the stock market, the SPY. And you really can't see it much on the daily because of all this like gap open stuff. It's up today. I mean, its volatility is in a high of 288, 28, its low is in at 287.50. Differential 50 plus 28 is 78 cents on two. I mean, that's about 0.25%. It's 9:44 a.m. This is what the market has done on the gap open. Okay, a little bit of a small gap open. Price action coming into the 18 average. And it's been in an uptrend. So what would we expect? Just continuation grinding to the upside until it doesn't anymore. And now let's check out. I know you can't read the name on here, and I could show it quickly, but I'm just going to take a look at what they say is the most volatile for today. It's a verb at a strong sell at 266. Let's take a look at it. I've never seen it before. It's a technology company. So if it's a strong sell, I think I should sell everything I got. I'm done. I sold zero of them, and I got nothing in return. But I didn't sell it, though, so technically that's like divide zero. Can't happen. Although, it's multiplication, which you can multiply zero. We have a gap down, 269. And we were in an uptrend. I mean, this to me would be... I mean, I don't understand where strong sell comes in. Because if it was so good that it was going to go down, why wouldn't you have sold higher? And yet, if it's a good coin, or stock rather, I always say coins on this probably because that's what I trade as far as the crypto verbiage is concerned. If I'm selling here at like 650 and 11, this is definitely volatile though, to say the least. 16, I'm buying back. But again, I have to ask that question if I'm playing that type of strategy. And okay, let's just assume I sell at 819 and I want to buy it back at 4. 405. Would I have got my buy-in? And closes at 580, it gaps at like under 3. Okay, well, let's just see long-term what this is all about. Okay, that's an inverted cup and handle formation. Wow, this is sickly volatile. Holy jeez, wow. I almost want to leave the crypto space to trade this. And I'm kidding, I don't want to, but wow. I mean, cryptos have the same volatility too, but you have a dollar, you go up to like 40. That's a 40x move. Not bad. Monthly chart, that's pretty much all it's been. It starts up, it goes down, and okay, let's see what else there is. Because they're saying to buy the VTL, which is a Therapies Incorporated company. Okay, I don't want to start off on the daily though. I want to, or monthly that is. Let's take a look at 4 hour even. Bitcoin. Nope. Vital Therapies. Okay, well this gapped higher. That's a sell, man. I mean, you get a gain like that. Why wouldn't you button down there? That's a sell in my book. Daily chart. Oh yeah, for sure. Back to a previous key level of resistance. I mean, all the buying you would have done down in here at like 21, now you got like 37. How could you not? Oh, wow. A strong buy. Okay. I would prefer on a buy in here for me to see something like, okay, we've established a level of resistance. Give me a few more weeks even. I mean, if it goes way up, it goes way up, but see it just settle in there, show something within the 18, and then maybe as the 18 is newly starting to rise and it's breaking out above 48, maybe at that point I can make a case to buy at these higher prices, but near on this move here, that was just, wow. Go from 940 down to 16. Was there any type of bull market before that could have gave you a whole whack of buybacks in there? And the answer is no. Okay, so this goes from 24. Wow, that's pretty wild. Not doing so well. And I'm going to finish it now. Definitely wouldn't recommend any of the strong buy, really. Really. I don't understand it. Thank you for tuning in. And I guess when you get those different sites that are like, oh, this is what we think. Oftentimes, if it's way up, they say buy. If it's way down, they say sell. It's and that's like the polar opposite of what I do. But in cases like this, hopefully, if this has been so good, what kind of missed news came in here and it's been a strong buy ever since this event, I suppose. But I would have guessed that when we look at the when you look at that site down when it was 15 cents, it would have said strong sell. Just saying. Thank you for tuning in. Have yourself a great day. Bye-bye.